Camera shakes are a really easy way to add dynamism to your edit. And in this video, I'm going to show you three different types of shakes. There's the impact shake that can be used just to amplify a certain area of the screen, for example, for a sports sequence. There's also the handheld camera movement. So if you have a tripod shot that's completely still and you want to add some gentle wiggle, that's another type of shake. And there's also shakes for transitions. Now in After Effects, it's easier to create camera shakes because of the wiggle effect. In Premiere Pro, it requires a little bit different approach, and we're going to be using Premiere Pro. All right, without further ado, let's go in and show you first how to do the impact shake. So here in my timeline, I have this basketball player, and every time the ball bounces, I want to add an impact shake. You'll notice that I added a marker at each ball bounce. And to create a marker on the clip, just select the clip and press M, and you will have a marker at that point. So to create the shake, we need to first create an adjustment layer. So go to the project panel, control click, and here I'm going to go to new item, adjustment layer, and then drag and drop the adjustment layer on top of this clip. And now we need to cut down the adjustment layer to the length that we want the shake to be. And usually it's pretty fast. In this case, I'm just going to do 10 frames. So I'm going to move the arrow key to the left 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Press C, cut, delete the excess, and then I'll go back to the center and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that way it's exactly 10 frames. Cut and delete that excess. And now we need to apply the transform effect. So go to effects and search for transform, and underneath distort, we'll drag and drop transform on the clip. Now the reason why we're not using the motion controls on top is because just using the motion controls, if I try to scale this up, nothing happens to the image beneath. Same with position, nothing happens. This is why we have to use transform. Notice when I scale this up, it directly impacts the clip below. So that's why we use the transform effect. And let's activate keyframes on position, scale, and rotation. That's the starting point. Then we'll go to the very end and click on create keyframe here on these three points. And now we have our end keyframe, and we can lasso and select them and just bring them over so it's directly at the end. Now we can go to the middle, and this is where we want the impact to be the biggest, right? So I'm going to scale this in first. Let's do about 130. And it scales in. We can also adjust the position so it's a little bit higher, and we can also play around with the rotation. Let's say -3. And to preview how it looks, I recommend going down to the timeline, going just before the adjustment layer and pressing I for in, and going just after and pressing O for out, and turning on loop playback. If you don't see this loop playback button, go here to the button editor and drag it down into your menu. So now when I hit play or the space bar, it's just going to loop. So now we can add a little bit more shake between the first two points and the last two points. So here, for example, I can go in and I can play around with the position a little bit, move it over. Same here, let's move this down, maybe to the right, and same here. Scale this down a bit, same here. In adding these position keyframes, all it's doing is adding more of a wobble. So when you play it back, you'll see it looks a bit more shaky. So now we can add a directional blur so it looks more realistic. So go to effects and search directional blur. Underneath blur and sharpen, drag and drop this on the adjustment layer. Same as before, we're going to go to the beginning, click the stopwatch to set a start keyframe, and then click add keyframe to create our endpoint here and move it over. And in the center, let's increase the blur length. So you can add as much as you want, just a subtle amount. I think around 40 is fine. And then you can adjust the direction just by clicking and dragging to create different types of movement. And so this is how it looks. So now if you want to duplicate this at every marker that I created in the beginning, we can go to the center point here to meet the marker. And now on the adjustment layer, we can press M to create a marker at the center point. So now if I duplicate it, I can line it up with the next marker. So I can press Option or Alt on a PC, click the adjustment layer, drag it, and drop it to line up exactly at this moment. And I'll do the same for the others. So now we can click above the timeline, control click, and clear the in and out. And now at each point, we have a shake. If you want to save this as a preset, you can go to any of these adjustment layers. You can select the transform and the directional blur by holding control on a PC or command on a Mac. And then you can control click or right click and save as preset, such as cam shake, and press OK. And this preset will now live in your presets folders right here that you can use in future projects. And welcome back. I'm Kelsey. If you haven't subscribed yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And if this video is helping you out so far, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Also on my store, premieregal.com/store, I put together a camera shake preset pack. So you can see that there's some subtle camera presets, faster ones, super shaky, and some impact shakes. And all you have to do is go to your effects panel, right click on the presets folder, and import the preset, and all 10 of them will appear here, nicely organized into short impacts and handheld. And the camera shakes work with both Mac and PC on Premiere Pro. And as you know, I've been primarily a Mac user. Right now I'm on the new M1 Max 16-inch MacBook Pro, and I love it. It's great. And throughout the years, I've always had people tell me, oh, you know,
Macs are much more secure than Windows. You don't need antivirus.
Well, actually, according to a recent report done, Macs are just as vulnerable as PCs. And I didn't know this, especially now with a lot more scams and crypto scams going on. It's important to protect your Mac. So to protect my Mac this year, I just started using an antivirus software by Intego called Mac Premium Bundle X9. Now this bundle comes first off with the virus barrier X9, which will scan your computer for any malware and remove it. There's also a net barrier X9, which creates a two-way firewall to prevent unauthorized users. There's a few other bonus things inside of the bundle, such as the Mac washing machine that will scan your computer and help you remove unnecessary data like duplicate media, passwords, etc., that will just eat up space on your computer. There's also content barrier. It's like parental control if you need something like that. And there's also a personal backup tool to backup your data. And Intego set up a 65% off offer for you if you use my link below, so definitely take advantage of that. I also recommend tacking on the premium VPN because it's important to encrypt your location so that way you also protect your computer. So thanks so much to Intego for sponsoring today's video and setting up the discount. And now let's return to the tutorial. All right, so now I'm going to show you how to do the handheld shake effect. So here inside of my timeline, I have this tripod shot. It's completely still, and I've already applied an adjustment layer on top throughout the entire clip. And I've also already applied the transform effect just like we did before. First, what I'm going to do is scale up the clip a bit because we need to have some wiggle room to be able to move the position back and forth. So here I'm going to scale this up to like 110, and it will depend on the shot. I'm not going to activate keyframes on the scale because I'm just going to be keyframing the position. So just click the stopwatch next position. And then we can do the same at the end. We can set an end keyframe as well. So between here, this is where we can just move the playhead forward a little bit and then subtly move the position up and down. Then move forward a little bit again and adjust the position a little bit more. So now you can see between these two points, we have a little bit of a shake. So what we need to do now is just repeat this throughout. And after you get the first set made, you can actually lasso and select them, and you can press Command C or Control C to copy, and then move forward a bit and press Command V to paste it. And then again, we can go and just copy a few of them here and paste them. All right, so I finished all of the keyframes, and to top it off, I'm going to click and lasso and select all of them and control click and select continuous bezier, so that way it's more smooth. So you can see that it changed from just a simple dot into sort of a time watch, like an hourglass, and that's exactly what we want. All right, so this is how the handheld movement looks as the final result. And if you don't want it to be as fast as I've done, you can actually scroll in here and see how much space I put between the keyframes. You can add more when you make yours. So rather than moving the playhead just a little bit and creating a keyframe, you can move it to create more of a gap and then make your first keyframe and then move forward a longer duration. So it's really up to you to decide how you want it to be, what speed you want it at. When they're closer together, it's going to be a faster movement. So the last type of transition is the shake transition between two clips. Here in my timeline, I have these two shots of these gals playing soccer, and I want to add a shake transition between them. So all I need to do is move my playhead directly at the cut point here. And I use a pack from AE Juice, the I Want It All bundle. If you want to check it out, you can click right up here. Inside of that bundle, there's seamless transitions. So I'm going to go up to Window. I've already installed the AE Juice Pack Manager extension. And here you can see that I have all these products as part of the bundle, but I like to use the seamless transitions. And inside of that are the shake transitions. So you can just hover over them to preview them. There's a lot to choose from. I'll just choose the second one here. And to apply it at this cut point, just double click. And it automatically imports that shake. And it includes a sound effect, which is why I love this pack. It's very, very useful. And then I'm just going to hit R to render it out. Just take a few seconds, and there's the result. So I didn't have to do anything. Of course, it's not my own product. It's by AE Juice, but I highly recommend it because it also includes many other different types of transitions, just not the shakes. So that's all for this camera shake tutorial. If this video helped you out, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're interested in checking out my own camera shake preset pack on my store, you can click right over here, and you can click over here to watch more videos on this channel. As always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.